Auster with the high wing, and the Chipmunk with the low wing. This is Kevin Hale in the Auster and Simon Tilley in the Chipmunk. So, paired because they both have the speed range going from as low as 40 knots to over 100 knots, or just over 100 knots. So we've spoken about the Chipmunk earlier on with the Auster. That's a Second World War aircraft, the Taylor Craft Auster to give it its full name. So the Auster, 75 years old, later this month on the 24th. Chipmunk in its 70s, one of the last airframes to be built at Arden in the UK, was transferred to the RAF at Middle Wallop in September 1953. When the Army Air Corps was formed on the 1st of September 1957, she was transferred to Army ownership and spent her whole military career in Middle Wallop until her last service flight in March 1977. She was then struck off charge and sold in April of that year for the princely sum of, what do you reckon? Have a guess how much for a Chipmunk in 1957. Ex-army, £19,000. Simon bought her in 2019, so she has been continuously airworthy from 1953 to today. Coming up to six to start because his wife wanted him to stop motor racing because it was just too hot. So he took a trial flying this and was hooked and got his private pilot's license in 6 months. He joined a group syndicate flying a Cessna 172, so a similar high wing design to the Auster. And then bought a Cherokee 140, flying that for a year, then took up aerobatics. Bought the Bulldog, the Scottish Aviation Bulldog, then took up air racing with the Royal Aero Club and won the British Championship in 2018 in the Bulldog. He recently sold that to buy a Yak 52 to race a third more complex aircraft. A chance conversation with long-time B-17 Sally B display pilot Bill Tomlin. He also runs ab initio displays, which is set up to provide air experience flights in the Chipmunk and in the Yak 52. So if anyone is interested in experiencing what for many is described as the poor man's Spitfire, that's the Chipmunk or the Yak 52, which he says is a bit of a mistake. A four-seat tourer and has a cruising speed of 180 knots, so that's just over 200 miles an hour. It's known as the SF-260 because it was designed by Italian aircraft engineer Stelio Fratti, and while production work was originally performed by Milan-based aviation manufacturer Avio Milan. It was July 1964 that the prototype made its maiden flight, and production responsibility was transferred to Sia Machetti, who purchased the rights to the design. A very pretty design it is too. Because of its looks and its performance, it's often referred to as the Ferrari of the skies. It's been largely sold to military customers as a trainer and a light combat aircraft because its handling characteristics are somewhat jet-like, but has all the maintenance advantages of the low-cost distance maintenance. There have been limited civil sales to private operators during the late 60s, and the type was marketed in the USA under the name Wacko Meteor. Armed military versions were sold as the SF-260W, the W standing for Warrior, and they proved to be popular with small air forces, which used the aircraft as a trainer and also arm it in the close air support. Piston-powered and turboprop-powered models have been developed. Our pilot, Paul, has been flying for more than 13 years with more than 400 hours logged on aircraft from the AT-3, the Beagle Pup, and the Slingsby Firefly, which he flew to get his aerobatics rate, which he achieved in 2016. He says that he never could get the hang of flying straight and level, so gave up and decided to become a display pilot instead. He received his display authorization in 2018. Although it has four seats, the rear seats are limited to 112 kilos, so not quite the aircraft to perhaps take four of your rugby mates to an overseas match. The maximum speed is 236 knots, so that's just over 250 miles an hour. It is extremely agile. It's aerobatically stressed to plus 6G and minus 3G. Paul says it really is a gentleman's grand touring aircraft, the sort of thing James Bond would perhaps fly when he's not driving an Aston Martin. And that's an interesting comment, because the turboprop version of this aircraft was actually used in the Bond film Quantum of Solace in 2008, where it was used to attack James Bond while he was making his escape in a Dakota DC-3. There's a nice topside view of that. Designed as a sports tourer, but unlike many of its competitors, also to possess aerobatic capabilities. It was also equipped to fly under instrument flight rules, so it had a full instrument panel. Sunny days like this, and he's waggling his wings. Let's give Paul a wave back. He looked like he was having fun there.